Yes, I welcome you to my channel today, and today we want to look at strategies to prevent hypertension. If you have hypertension or you have somebody that have hypertension, I think this post is just for you. Keep watching.
All right. I decided to talk on hypertension today because lot of things are happening around me, and I know it happens in many parts of the world. If you take a careful look at the latest news around the health sector, you notice that hypertension is one of the major cause of death in the world right now. And in my area alone, around me, around some family members and friends, just last week, I received bad news concerning hypertension, that somebody died of BP. If you look at this one, died, at least for the past 2 weeks, three people have died that I know. And I was asking myself that how on earth these people died. And many, after the autopsy, the result, people said that she died of BP. He died of BP, and he died of BP and other things. And in our last book, we talk about stroke and some of the strategies we can help you prevent stroke from happening to you in the future or later in life. But today, we want to look at how strategies that help you manage or prevent hypertension, for you dying of hypertension and all those things. So we are going to carefully look at some of those things you need to do. I call them strategy because those are some of the most things you must do so that you can help you prevent you from having hypertension or for you dying of hypertension. And so we just sit back, and we also need to learn learn a few things about this. Hypertension is a disease of the heart, and it happens when the systolic and diastolic reading of the heart, when the blood pressure is being raised beyond the normal or below the normal. When it raised beyond the normal, it's called hypertension. But when it's drained below the normal, then it is called hypotension. So the diastolic reading and diastolic reading have a particular readings, which if you have the high blood pressure meter, then you can actually check yours by yourself. Hypertension happens as a result of high blood pressure. When the high blood pressure is irregular, and when it's too high, it can lead to hypertension, which is a disease of the heart. And it has been also a disease that causes so many things. It can lead to stroke. In fact, one of the major causes of stroke for people, can lead to other things, other heart-related, cardiac arrest, heart-related issues. It can also cause diabetes, because there's a link that shows that hypertension and diabetes are kind of related, although not in everybody. So is one of the causes of death in the world is hypertension, because at the end of the day, somebody will just die, and the person die of high BP, high blood pressure. That's hypertension. When anybody dies of high blood pressure, is like a walking corpse. And let me just tell you this thing. Somebody died of hypertension in my area, and I think some people were fighting, and she went there to make peace. As she was there trying to separate the fight, somebody just pushed her. People, mommy, you need to go back. And she just went down and she died. And people were like, what happened to her? Is it diabolic? Is it fetish? And at the end of the day, they noticed that she already have a high BP. So if you have high BP, then you need to know that definitely you are suffering from hypertension. And some of the signs and symptoms of hypertension includes heartbeats, irregular heartbeat, or when your heartbeat beat faster, many times irregular body temperature, and your chest keep hitting, just mild headache and loss of balance, loss of memory, and many times tiredness, excessive urination, and all those things. So that those are some of the symptoms of hypertension. And one of the best ways you can prevent hypertension, which I think the strategy is you need to go to the doctor, as long as you are around age 40 and above. Before, it used to be age 50, age 60, but now if you are age 40 and above, after celebrating your birthday at 40th, your 40th birthday should be for you to go to the hospital, examine yourself, and start a new life. And if you are past age 40 and you have not been to the doctor, if as you are celebrating your next 50 years birthday, go to a doctor, visit the hospital, and start checking yourself. Check your heart blood pressure, check your sugar level, check your salt level. And if you do that, I bet you are going to be very, very healthy compared to people that just live natural attitude, smoking, and all those things. Now let us look at some of the strategies that help you prevent hypertension from happening to you. The first one is check your blood pressure. It's not a must. If you go to any clinic, either private or public, as you're entering the clinic, the first thing you need to do is to check your blood pressure. Either you are young or old, because they know that blood pressure is not something you write on the forehead. So if you don't write that on the forehead, then you just have to check You have to check your blood pressure generally, regularly. Either you have high blood pressure or you have low pressure, or you have none. If you have none, make sure you have. In fact, if the government is supposed to make it compulsory for anybody above age 40, 50, or 45 to have a blood pressure kit at home, so they can actually check this thing day in, day out, weekly, monthly, and all this, without even seeing a doctor. So there are some strategies that help prevent hypertension without seeing a doctor. So those are some of the things we are trying to. But no matter how you are seeing the doctor, you must see a doctor. The first strategy is you must go to your doctor, examine your BP. If you have high BP or low BP, the doctor he knows what to do, because the doctor knows what to do. He's going to place you on medication. He's going to place you on things, on therapy or on drugs that will help you suppress it, that will help you monitor it. Hypertension kills people, and I don't pray for you to die at an early age, because now I don't know about worries. People worry more, people hustle more, people work more, and it's really telling on people are dying. So if you want to live, you must have a strategy of preventing hypertension from happening to you, and that's one of the things you need to go see your doctor, examine yourself. The doctor will ask you to get to, the doctor can even recommend a very good electronic BP checker for you, that the sphygmomanometer. You will check you, so you can actually do it from home at yourself. Anytime you feel weak, anytime you feel tired, anytime you feel worried, check your BP. Because if you cultivate the habit of checking your BP almost every time, then I bet you are fit, and nothing will happen to you in the future. So make it a limit, try to see your doctor and check your high BP every time. And prevention, you have high BP, then the doctor is going to recommend some drugs, some BP drugs for you, which can help you control or manage your high blood pressure, and so that you can help you avoid getting hypertension or dying of hypertension. Then the next strategy, which I believe that it works for people, and as I'm working, is for you to avoid smoke. Smoking don't only affect the lungs also, but you are inhaling smoke. You are inhaling very terrible thing. You are inhaling nicotine inside your lungs, which also affects your heart as well. So anything that affects the heart causes blood pressure. So the first thing is, the next thing you're going to do is for you to avoid smoking. No matter the age, smoking is not meant for you. It's not good for you. Smokers are liable to die young. So if you know that you are smoking, I think find a way of reducing it and stopping it within the shortest period of time, because it's one of the causes of high blood pressure, which is a result of hypertension. So if I'm going to choose a strategy for you, then I'll say that strategy for you to prevent hypertension at any age, at old age, is for you to stop smoking. And the other one is also alcohol intake. Yeah, as you're smoking, it is your alcohol intake also. Alcoholic drinks, the end product of those ones are sugar. And since alcoholism is sugar related, then it can cause stroke and it can also lead to hypertension. So I think you need to do away with that, especially if you are older in age. You also need to stop excessive consumption of salt. Adding more salt to your food or eating too much of processed food which are preserved with salt. Salt contains sodium ion, which at times the basic function of sodium ion in salt is for osmotic pressure for the heart to punch over. And when it is becoming too much, then it affects you. If it affects the heart, it affects the blood vessels and that, which causes a tiny heart disease like hypertension. So you need to stop taking too much of salt, only if the doctor asks you not to do so. But averagely, for people who are older in age, then you need to stop taking salt, and that. So that's also a private. So if you're going to consider a nice strategy that helps you prevent hypertension or that make you prevent death from hypertension happening to you later in your life, then you have to, at a particular age, age 40, age 45, age 50, then you need to do with salt. Then next, as you're going away with salt, you're also going away, you're also reducing sugar as well. If you are the type that eats more of sugar, sugary drinks or sugary food or sugar-related food, and you may have diabetes if you're not careful. And if you don't have diabetes, then excess sugar in food or excess soft drinks can also cause high blood pressure for you. So you don't need to, because many times sugar converted to glycogen, which also is fatty material, makes you add weight. And before you know it, you'll be putting yourself in trouble of hypertension. So that's that. You also look at overweight. I used to tell people that being overweight at age 50, at age 40, is one thing you need to prevent. So if you are overweight, try as much as possible to prevent this overweight nature. Go for exercises, either cardio exercise or those normal exercises. Cardio exercise reduces faster, because those are some of the skipping exercises, stairs climbing, then anything that makes you break faster, those are cardio exercises. You can do that two or three times a week. Or if you can, if you don't have that time, you can also do simple exercises like walking. You can do something like yoga. You can do stretching. You can do jogging, and you can do cycling. I think you have cycling machines everywhere now that helps you. So if you want to clear your heart, you have to exercise. Exercise ensures that blood flows through all the blood vessels, from the vessels to the arteries to the veins, and which will not even allow high blood pressure to stand or to stay in your body. So if you seek a very good strategy for you to do all that, then you need exercises. Now, not only exercise, you also need to look at food. Don't eat fast foods. Reduce your intake of fatty foods, your intake of high calorie, not only fatty, but high calorie foods, so that you can actually maintain your weight. Your weight also determines. Also, this somebody died, and I do. The man is very tall and big and fat, so he died after some. I think he did some videos, and the third day he died, and people were like, "What, my cousin?" In my heart, I already know that it's BP that probably killed the man, because the man is tall and he's huge and he's fat. So with that thing, then he's going to suffer hypertension, which he didn't know. Then BP they don't write it on the forehead, so he should know that, or the wife should know that at this age, he needs to take care of his weight and all this. Then the next one is stress also. Stressful activities for people who are for matured adult, for grown people. If you are stressing yourself a little, they can lead to hypertension as well. So if you need also a strategy to help you prevent hypertension, then you need to go away with stress. Don't stress yourself. Stressful activities are not for you. If you are stressed up, then like the man I told you that he died of stressful activities. At that age, somebody who is fat and big and is going for skipping nights and all. So you need to sleep very well. At a particular age, you need to sleep very well. Avoid overnight walks or excessive nights. Keeping night and all those things, you need to sleep. Find your sleep, because when you sleep, it puts the brain at rest and the heart pumps and the heart operates normally. So you need to sleep very well and that. So you also need to just do away with fatty foods, salty foods, and all those. So all these strategies put together will help you in a very simple way, without spending so much money, without seeing a doctor, without going to the hospital to help you prevent hypertension or death due to hypertension. So you can also use the comment box, put your comments where we can also gain from you. Ask any question, ask us question, or just help drop a comment about what you have been using that helps you to prevent hypertension, or have you been managing hypertension with the doctor or without going to see a doctor. We'd be much appreciated to learn from you. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel so that you can get more health tips from us. Thank you.